Flight 8 has just come to a close, and we've already revealed our first major insight into the upcoming mission. SpaceX's esteemed leader, Elon Musk, has officially revealed the launch date for Flight 9, and it's bold, ambitious, and downright jaw-dropping. Heading into the latest flight challenge, Musk's confidence is sky high. So when can we expect Flight 9 to launch? What's driving Musk's unwavering confidence, and how is SpaceX preparing for this next major step? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio. Flight 8 has arguably emerged as one of the most exhilarating and intense spaceflight missions to date. Marked by pre-flight delays due to technical hurdles and palpable tension surrounding the Super Heavy's capture attempt, especially after its engine failure. The entire mission was a tumultuous emotional ride, culminating in the ship's dramatic voyage, which ended with a spectacular finale reminiscent of Flight 7. Despite the odds, SpaceX was able to achieve another major milestone. Super Heavy has successfully achieved another landing using the Mechazilla arm, further cementing the company's commitment to full reusability. Meanwhile, Starship has suffered another catastrophic failure, highlighting the significant challenges that remain to be overcome. In the immediate aftermath of the flight, a flurry of updates from SpaceX and the FAA turned everyone's attention to one man, Elon Musk. Musk has curiously refrained from directly commenting on the flight, leading many to speculate about the underlying dynamics. When he finally did speak out, however, he drew significant attention with a series of bold statements. None was more surprising than his revelation about the schedule for Flight 9. He initially acknowledged the setback, tweeting, "Today was a modest hurdle. The recurrence of the same issues from Flight 7 on Flight 8 indicated that the improvements SpaceX had implemented had not yet reached their full potential." In the rapidly evolving field of aerospace innovation, stagnation equals setbacks. Musk later posted two additional tweets, commenting on the challenges of achieving multiplanetary existence. It was indeed a failure of the upper stage slash ship. However, we gained significant insights during the development of the new ship design and subsequent flights. What is particularly noteworthy is Musk's candor. He candidly admitted the failure, a feat that many leaders might approach with trepidation. But in true SpaceX style, he emphasized the insights gained and the relentless ambition to move forward. Then came the big announcement. Progress is measured by the passage of time. The subsequent vessel is anticipated to be prepared within a time frame of 6 weeks. That is a remarkably ambitious timeline. Should Musk's estimation prove accurate, Flight the 9th of May potentially launch as soon as the initial week of April, or at the latest by mid-April. Considering the obstacles faced by Flight 8, this ambition may appear audacious. However, upon closer examination, it is quite attainable. The primary advantage that SpaceX currently possesses is its wealth of experience. The challenges encountered with Flight 8 predominantly mirrored those observed in Flight 7, encompassing engine leaks, fires, and failures that ultimately resulted in the vessel losing control. We also observed analogous formations of detritus and charred remnants discernible from considerable distances. Super Heavy experienced additional engine malfunctions during its boostback burn, with one engine unable to successfully restart prior to landing. Although these issues may appear significant, SpaceX has been actively examining them since Flight 7. As they are not required to commence from the beginning, they can merely augment their current analysis and hone the solutions they have already been developing. Consequently, the inquiry into Flight 8 is anticipated to progress more swiftly, allowing for necessary enhancements to be implemented with greater efficiency. Furthermore, the regulatory challenges may prove to be less pronounced on this occasion. Given that the mission parameters for Flight 9 are expected to remain stable, it is plausible that SpaceX will not require an amended launch license from the FAA. The primary determinant affecting FAA approval will be the environmental and safety ramifications of the explosion. Should there be an absence of substantial damage and no threat to public safety, the inquiry and sanctioning procedure may conclude swiftly. In comparison, the FAA required approximately 6 weeks to grant approval for Flight 8 subsequent to Flight 7, resulting in a reduced turnaround time of 7 weeks. However, as the agency continues to optimize its procedures, and considering there are no significant alterations to the mission, it is conceivable that Flight 9's approval could be obtained even more expeditiously. John Edwards, the Vice President of Falcon Launch Vehicles at SpaceX, accentuated the company's unwavering momentum in a recent tweet. Persevere relentlessly. Following Falcon 1 Flight 3, we came to the profound realization that the night is often at its most oppressive just prior to the arrival of dawn. Maintain your resolve and perseverance. Success is within our reach. The prevailing circumstances substantiate this perspective. The hardware for Flight 9 is progressing through its testing phases with exceptional rapidity. B-16 has been subjected to cryogenic testing at Massey. Subsequently, it will be returned to the production facility for the installation of the engine, prior to its journey to the launch pad for static fire testing. Concurrently, the S-35 is anticipated to adhere to a comparable schedule, undergoing its cryogenic and static fire tests prior to its integration with the booster. A significant advantage in this context is that the testing schedule for Starship is not solely reliant on the launch pad, which facilitates the simultaneous preparation of various components. Furthermore, the launch pad has undergone rapid refurbishment following recent flights, thus rendering it improbable that any delays will occur. Should all proceed as planned, SpaceX may complete the preparations for Flight 9 within the forthcoming 4 to 6 weeks. In light of the swift turnaround, it is conceivable that integration testing may be bypassed, akin to the approach taken with Flight 8, thereby further expediting the timeline. The mission profile for Flight 9 is anticipated to largely maintain its current parameters. Super Heavy will make another attempt at landing, utilizing the Mechazilla arms, and if accomplished, this will signify the third successive recovery of the booster. Concurrently, Starship will concentrate on enhancing its in-space operations, which encompass payload deployment, orbital engine performance, re-entry with upgraded heat shielding and engine safeguards, culminating in a controlled ocean landing. All indicators suggest an impending launch, rendering this the opportune moment for forecasting. I am placing my confidence in April 20th, initiating precisely 2 years subsequent to the inaugural flight of Starship. What are your thoughts? Please share your predictions in the comments section below, and while you're at it, convey your support for the SpaceX team by typing, "Let's go number 9. Notwithstanding the challenges encountered, SpaceX persists in its forward momentum, embodying the unwavering determination that has characterized the company since its inception. Musk has established a challenging timeline. However, if any organization is capable of overcoming such an obstacle, it is undoubtedly SpaceX. Should Flight 9 proceed according to expectations, the subsequent significant milestone will be Flight 10, which may ultimately endeavor to achieve a complete capture of Starship utilizing the Mechazilla arms. Although it is regrettable that this will not transpire in Flight 9, the postponement affords SpaceX additional opportunity to enhance Tower B and guarantee a successful inaugural endeavor in capturing the Super Heavy. Regardless of what transpires henceforth, it is unequivocal that SpaceX is etching its name in history with each launch, and we are collectively observing the evolution of spaceflight as it unfolds before our eyes. Therefore, ensure that you do not overlook a moment of the excitement. Engage with the video, subscribe to our channel, and remain attentive as we chronicle SpaceX's remarkable journey. Collectively, we shall observe as Starship embarks on its subsequent monumental journey towards the cosmos. SpaceX must refine several other essential systems prior to undertaking their primary objective, with the re-entry process representing one of the most significant challenges. In contrast to the Super Heavy, which requires merely to withstand a fleeting atmospheric descent, Starship must endure intense thermal conditions and aerodynamic stresses during its re-entry from orbit. To address this issue, substantial enhancements to the heat shield system are imperative. In the wake of the challenges encountered with Ship 29, or S-29 for brevity, during flight, SpaceX has undertaken a thorough examination of various enhancements. It is improbable that this will involve newly developed heat-resistant materials and the potential implementation of an ablative system. These enhancements seem to extend into Ship version 2, featuring supplementary cooling systems and metallic tiles currently undergoing evaluation. Naturally, these improvements will persistently develop in response to post-flight evaluations and empirical performance data. Subsequently, the flap system necessitates meticulous oversight. Although it signifies a significant advancement in V2 relative to V1, it remains to be comprehensively evaluated under genuine flight conditions. SpaceX should critically evaluate its operational efficacy in forthcoming missions, especially within the demanding conditions of re-entry. The flaps play a pivotal role in regulating descent and stability, thereby ensuring that the Starship retains the appropriate orientation prior to entering the landing phase. Should any deficiencies arise, additional enhancements will be required. The engines represent another critical domain for enhancement. The malfunction encountered during Flight 7, which abruptly curtailed Ship 33's mission, highlighted the critical significance of dependable propulsion systems. Deceleration, navigation, and landing are all contingent upon the flawless performance of the engines. A singular misstep at an inopportune juncture has the potential to compromise the entirety of a mission. SpaceX must enhance the dependability of Raptor engines, ensuring their capability to withstand the rigors of both spaceflight and the demanding landing procedures. In addition to the Starship itself, the ground systems must also be adequately prepared for the recovery endeavor. Recent conjecture indicates that Tower B is expected to serve as the site for the inaugural ship catch. The tower has been fully constructed, with the initial sections of its chopsticks in place, while additional components for the orbital launch mount are currently under development. The chopsticks, engineered to capture the Starship during its descent, will be the primary emphasis, necessitating meticulous coordination with the vehicle. Essential components, including landing pins, landing rails, and actuators, require precise calibration to guarantee an optimal alignment with the Starship's landing points. Furthermore, the communication system of the tower will undergo fortification, as it is imperative to avert scenarios similar to the abort incident experienced during Flight 6. Simultaneously, forthcoming test flights will play a pivotal role in pinpointing and addressing any outstanding issues. SpaceX is tasked with accomplishing a number of outstanding objectives, which encompass payload deployment, controlled reentry, and landing, all integrated with the latest V2 enhancements. Concurrently, it is essential to sustain and enhance prior achievements, such as the successful landing of super heavy vehicles and the relighting of engines in space. Ultimately, achieving proficiency in a controlled vertical landing for Starship represents the pivotal step preceding the endeavor of executing a complete Mechazilla catch. With each test flight, SpaceX gets closer to this pivotal moment, and anticipation continues to build as these critical systems are evaluated. Now let's dive into the exciting developments surrounding Virgin Galactic's bold new venture this month. The company is set to begin assembly of its unveiled next-generation suborbital spacecraft, the Delta spacecraft, marking a major milestone in its bold strategic vision. The major announcement was made directly by Virgin Galactic executives during an earnings call on February 6th, where they confirmed that assembly will take place at their state-of-the-art facility near Phoenix, Arizona. This is significant progress on the company's trajectory toward commercial flight operations, which are anticipated to begin in mid-2026, following a series of comprehensive test flights scheduled to begin in the spring of that year. Virgin Galactic CEO Michael Colglazier confidently asserted, "The production and launch schedule for our new spacecraft is on track as anticipated, with our first commercial research spaceflight projected for summer 2026. Followed by the debut of private astronaut spaceflights in the fall of 2026. We are able to refine our schedule projections because we have clear visibility into the delivery dates of each tool and component that is an integral part of the assembly process." Additionally, Colglazier emphasized the substantial progress Virgin Galactic has made, both internally and in collaboration with suppliers. Critical components and sub-assemblies are currently being prepared for shipment to the Phoenix facility, where they will undergo final assembly and comprehensive testing. The company is positive about the pace of its testing phase, especially since the construction of the Delta spaceship is informed by insights gained from VSS Unity, the suborbital spacecraft that Virgin Galactic decommissioned last summer. With this foundation, the testing process is expected to be smooth and highly efficient. After the start of the research flight phase for the Delta spaceship, Virgin Galactic intends to conduct 6 to 10 flights, carrying a variety of payloads, company personnel, and eventually private astronauts. As the company expands its operational capacity, it intends to increase its launch frequency to twice a week. Colglazier explained, "We will gradually increase our efforts over time. However, I anticipate that by 2027, or perhaps as early as January 1st of that year, we will be operating at the pace that we have discussed previously." In addition to facilitating private astronaut launches, Virgin Galactic is also exploring the potential for deeper space missions, including surveillance and reconnaissance initiatives for government entities. This is a notable expansion of the company's vision, one that positions it in direct competition with leading industry leaders. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.